morning, children. Here we are with the second part of the video of Civics Chapter 4, Growing Up as Boys and Girls. In the previous video, we have discussed about the life in the Samoa Island in 1920s, life in Madhya Pradesh in 1960s. We have also discussed about how different roles are assigned in our society for males and females. Children, before proceeding further, I would ask all of you to read the comic strip which is given in your civics book on page number 47. Okay, children, the story starts with a girl asking her mother that this time her mother should volunteer for the school excursion. The name of the girl is Sonali. Sonali asks her mother that this time her mother should volunteer for the school excursion, as every time her friends Harmeet's mother always volunteer for the school excursion, as she is a housewife and she doesn't work. When Sonali's mother came to know about this, she was very surprised to hear that. She asked her daughter that how can she say that Harmeet's mother doesn't work. Sonali was surprised and told her mother that what is wrong in that. Harmeet's mother do not go to any office, so that means she doesn't work. When Sonali's mother heard all about this, she decided that next day she will take her daughter to Harmeet's house.
Children, now let us read the comic strip. My mother does not work. Ma, we are going on a school excursion. Rosie ma'am needs volunteers. Can't you take a holiday from office and volunteer? Harmeet's mother always comes for excursion because she doesn't work. Sonali, how can you say that? You know that Jaspreet auntie is up at 5 a.m. every day doing all the housework. Yes, but that's not real work. It's just housework. Oh, that's what you think. Do you? Let's go over to their house and ask Jaspreet what she thinks. At the Singh's house. Harsharan, Sonali thinks that your wife is not a working person. But isn't that correct, auntie? My mother is a housewife. She does not work. Ha ha. Then just breathe. Why don't you just relax and let them manage everything for a change? Great idea. Okay, I will go on strike tomorrow. What fun. We will take care of everything tomorrow with Papa. Next morning, 7:30 a.m. Oh God, look at the time. Where's my breakfast? Why aren't the children ready? How would I know? I am on strike, remember? Besides, Mangala has also taken leave today. Honk, honk. Oh ho, there's the school bus. I will have to drop them in the car. Hurry, hurry, and ask Harmeet to switch on the pump. But what about kids' lunch boxes? Oh no, forgot about that. I will give you some money. Just buy something from the canteen today. Ma already gave us money for that. Evening, 6 p.m. Ding ding. I'm exhausted. How about some tea? Oh, I forgot you are strike. I will make some for myself. The house looks like it was hit by a hurricane. Did you expect it to remain in exactly the same condition in which you left it this morning, dear? Harmeet, Where on earth are the tea leaves? I wonder if they still believe I don't work, and now I have to remind them that Chacha ji and Chachi ji are coming for dinner. So children, after reading the comic story, we can easily make out that Hermes' family did not think that the work Jaspreet did within the house was real work. This feeling is not unique to their families. Across the world, the main responsibility for housework and caregiving tasks like looking after the family, especially children, the elderly and sick members, lies with the women. Yet, as we have seen, the work that women do within the home is not recognized as work. It is also assumed that this is something that comes naturally to women. It therefore does not have to be paid for, and society devalues this work. Our family structure creates a great impact on the individual's behavior in society, in the family, and at the workplace. Early in life, traits of dependency and helplessness are instilled in women. Boys are allowed more freedom during childhood, while freedom for girls is much less, and they are expected to take on their future role as mother or caretaker from their early years. Gender-based social roles define the nature, the type of activities taken up by women and men. In most societies, the role of women is limited to looking after the home and family. They are kept away from social roles beyond the confines of the family. Accordingly, they are also discriminated against in education and employment opportunities. Their hard work is not counted as economically productive. Financially, they are always dependent on men. This has led to men controlling women. Children, our next topic is women's work and equality. As we have seen, the low value attached to the women's household and caregiving work is not an individual or family matter. It is a part of a larger system of inequality between men and women. It therefore has to be dealt with through actions not just at the level of individual or the family, but also by the government. As we know, equality is an important principle of our constitution. The constitution says that being male or female should not become a reason for discrimination. In reality, inequality between the sexes exists. The government is therefore committed to understanding the reason for this and taking positive steps to remedy the situation. For example, the government has set up Anganwadis or childcare centers in several villages. The government has passed laws that make it mandatory for organizations that have more than 30 women employees to provide creche facilities. The provision of creche helps many women to take up employment outside the home. It also makes it possible for more girls to attend schools.
So children, there have been many movements focusing on giving women economic rights. A number of government programs have been launched to improve the condition of women in our society. Things are changing for better. Now today, more girls are going to school, more women are coming out of their homes for taking jobs, they are getting more engaged in social work and even political areas. So all these things show that there is lots of improvement in our society now. This has helped many of them to be self-confident and financially independent. Nowadays, both men and women, they are working together. This is a great achievement for our society. So children, that's all for this chapter. More to come in new videos. Till then, goodbye.